We recently took a trip to Ghent, Belgium. Despite living so close to Belgium, we haven't actually spent much time there yet. So we were eager to check out what we've heard is one of the country's prettiest cities. Ghent certainly did not disappoint, and it is definitely a foodie city. Stay tuned to discover this beautiful city with us. Welcome to Turks Who Eat. We're Alex and Mehmet, a couple who loves to travel and eat. We also bring our dog, Bindi, along with us for as many adventures as possible. We love traveling, and eating local foods tends to be the highlight of our travels. We love to discover the local dishes and learn how to make them ourselves. Follow along with us as we explore the world, discover local foods, and attempt to recreate them. Ghent is located in the Flanders region of Belgium, not far from the Dutch border. It's a charming city full of well-preserved medieval architecture and picturesque canal-lined streets. And, very importantly, it is full of great food. Belgium is famous for its fries, and there are plenty of great frites to try in Ghent. We tried a couple of places, but our favorite was definitely a small spot called Fritter Bij Philip. It's easy to miss, but if you look for the line near the Grote Market in the center of the city, you're sure to find it. Don't be deterred if the line is long. It moves fast, and the fries are totally worth it. After devouring our fries, we went in search of some great chocolate, which wasn't difficult because Ghent has tons of amazing chocolate shops. The stores have a very fancy yet approachable feel, and many showcase some crazy sculptures and items made from chocolate. Wandering through these chocolate shops, it's amazing to see what they can make out of chocolate. The small chocolates on display are just as mesmerizing. They often look like jewels, and it's almost impossible to believe that these are all edible. We decided to get a box of assorted chocolates so we could taste a bunch of them. Each one was unique, filled with flavors such as mango chili, pistachio, and praline. Each one is also beautiful to look at. We really enjoyed the chocolate in Ghent, and we picked up a few chocolate bars that we'll be using to make a Belgian chocolate cake when we're back home, so keep an eye out for that upcoming recipe. Despite having so much chocolate, we were ready for a few more sweets and headed to Himschut Bakery. Himschut is believed to have opened in 1880 and is considered the oldest bakery in Ghent. It's a tiny, yet cute shop that offers quite a variety given its small size. We opted for a donut-like pastry that was covered in powdered sugar and filled with jam. The outside was soft and fluffy, and the jam was flavorful but not overly sweet. It left me covered in powdered sugar, but the pastry was too good to care about that. The next time we're in Ghent, we will definitely be back to try more from this place. Of course, as you probably know, Belgium is famous for its beer, and there are plenty of places to try local brews in Ghent. We stopped into Café Gelgenhuis, which has an interesting, yet somewhat dark history. Famous for being the smallest pub in Ghent, Gelgenhuis is located on an old square where the public could watch criminals being publicly punished in the Middle Ages. Today, it is a tiny but cozy little pub offering some great Belgian beers. We also visited a great wine bar, which unfortunately we didn't take any footage of, but we'll link it with our recommendations below. While we consider chocolate, fries, and beer to be a totally worthwhile meal, it's likely that at some point you might be looking for something more balanced. And of course, Ghent is full of great sit-down restaurants. One surprising find for us was a nice Asian restaurant called Steamy Windows. Here we enjoyed a number of dumplings and buns, including one of our favorites, a sweet custard bun, for dessert. We also had a great dinner at a local favorite, Mem Gusta. Here they're serving up traditional Flemish cuisine in a modern but cozy setting. And of course, many of the orders come with a towering portion of fries, so what's not to love? There are also a number of cute little cafes to stop into for a coffee, a cake, or of course, a Belgian waffle. While we could have happily spent our entire trip here just eating, we took a break from the food to check out some of the local sites. One of the most famous landmarks in Ghent is the Gravensteen, a medieval castle dating back to the 12th century. The castle was built for Count Philip and served as the power seat for following Counts of Flanders for over two centuries. The castle has been beautifully well preserved, and a ticket to the castle includes an audio guide by a local comedian, which is actually quite funny and makes this a unique way to explore a historic site. The tour will give you an idea of what life here was like in the Middle Ages, and from the top of the castle, you can take in some amazing views over the city. Another notable site in Ghent is the St. Bavo's Cathedral. Basic ticket costs €12.50, and normally we're not fans of paying to visit religious sites, but I would say this one is worth it, as the entire upstairs of the cathedral is basically a museum leading up to one of the world's most famous works of art, the Ghent altarpiece. Also known as the Adoration of the Mystic Lamb, this work of art is stunning to see. I remember learning about it in art history classes, but to see it in person is really amazing. The piece was created by Hubert and Jan van Eyck in 1432 and is known for its amazing amount of detail and symbolism. This masterpiece is massive and it is surrounded by ornate marble and stained glass. A walk through the cathedral is definitely worthwhile for anyone with an interest in art. Ghent also has a number of cute, local shops, and many that will be of interest to foodies. There's a great shop called Books and Booze, located in the center of the city. This is a really unique place that pairs books with related alcohols for a perfect pairing. We found some really unique books and bottles in the shop, and the friendly owner helped us pick out a perfect gift. They sell books in many languages, and even some in Turkish, so don't worry about not being able to find something if you don't speak Dutch or Flemish. Another great shop to stop into is the Turintian Verlant Mustard Shop. This shop dates back to at least the early 1800s and still creates and sells mustard in a very traditional way, in big wooden vats located in an ancient Romanesque cellar beneath the shop, and pouring the mustard directly into small pots upon order. The experience here was great, and we really liked the mustard as well. It's super spicy. We might be needing to make future trips to Ghent just to remain stocked up on this mustard. Ghent is also famous for its picturesque canals that run through the city. Over the centuries, these canals have been important for trade, defense, and transportation. Today, they are viewed as a reminder of the historic importance of this city, as well as a popular touristic attraction. There are plenty of boat tours running along the canals, and many cafes and restaurants set up terraces in front of the water. We ended our time in Ghent by having a lovely little picnic by the canals. We visited a very nice cheese shop, where the shop worker helped us pick out two delicious cheeses, which we enjoyed with some snacks along the water. And of course, Bindi had a snack as well. It was truly the perfect end to our time in Ghent. Before we wrap up, we'll just quickly mention that Ghent was very dog-friendly, and it was a very easy city to visit with Bindi. Of course, Bindi wasn't allowed in the castle or the cathedral, which is expected, but we had no problems dining with her. She was even allowed into the chocolate shops. We did notice one cafe we were interested in had a no dog sign, but they also had a terrace, so if it hadn't been raining, we could have sat outside with her. We hope you enjoyed learning more about this beautiful city. We'll list all of our favorite places out below. Give us a thumbs up if you like this video, and subscribe if you want to see where we're headed next.